Hi, I'm Mr. Manoj, and today we're going to have a look at some of the IGCSE questions, IGCSE Chemistry. This is 0620 syllabus code, and I'm going to have a look at some of the mole concept questions from some past paper questions here. I'm going to begin with 2012. So before we start, why don't you make sure that you grab a calculator, a couple of sheets, and make sure that you have your past papers with you. So let's have a look. Okay, I think by now you must be ready with everything. Now, if you open paper 32 for May 2012, there is a question number 7, E part, which has a chemical calculation question there. And the question says there is alkene 0.01 moles, and they give you, interestingly, the mass of oxygen 2.4 and the mass of carbon dioxide as 2.2 grams. Well, if you notice carefully, they're not in the same, they're not compatible. This is moles and these are masses in grams. So we need to make them compatible before we start looking into the mole ratios. Now, since these are molecules, so the first thing you must think of is to convert them into moles. Now, remember, to find the moles of molecules, the formula used is N equals to M over MR. This stands for mass in grams, and that's the molar mass which you will get from the periodic table. Now, don't forget, from this year onwards, 2016, the periodic table has a slight modification. The AR, for example, of oxygen in the older periodic tables, it was written on the top. Now it is at here. So that's the AR, 16, and carbon's AR is 12, and that's the atomic number. Now, the mass of oxygen given is 2.4, so I'm going to put 2.4 here. And to find the MR, I look at my periodic table. The AR of oxygen is 16, but because I see 2 here, I times it by 2. So 16 times 2. And this works out to be, if you check with your calculator, 2.4 divided by 32 gives us 0.075. And that's the moles of oxygen that we got. Similarly, why don't you try to find the moles of carbon dioxide? Okay, let's have a look. Did you get the same answer or not? Now, the moles of carbon dioxide, the formula once again has to be M over MR. Don't forget, that's the formula to find the moles of somebody who is in the form of a molecule. If you work with an atom, the formula becomes N equals to M over AR. As of now, since you're dealing with molecule, so we write here MR. If you put the numbers in, I have the mass of carbon dioxide as 2.2 divided by the MR of carbon dioxide. So my AR of carbon is 12, so that's 12. Plus I have two atoms of oxygen, that is 2 into 16. So when you work this out, you get 2.2 divided by, that's 44, and you get 0.05 moles. So if you have a look what we have so far, we have the moles of alkene, I have the moles of oxygen, and I have the moles of carbon dioxide. So I'm going to write this in an organized way. Okay, so now we have all the moles in one place, and our next objective is to convert this into a simple ratio. Now, convert this into a simple ratio means we need to divide all three by the smallest number possible, which in this case is 0.01. So I'm going to divide all of them by the smallest number. And this gives me a simple ratio, 1, 7.5, and 5. But it's not really simple at this point of time. You notice this is a decimal, 7.5. I cannot round this up to 8. I cannot round this down to 7. So that means I need to now think of a smallest number possible, which, if I multiply all three of them, should give me a nearest whole number. Basically, we need to try this out one by one. So let's say I'm going to try this by 2. If I times this by 2, this one becomes 2, that's a whole number. This becomes 15, which is a whole number, and that becomes 10. So it's good. In a situation where you sometimes are faced with 1.3, you know, some other decimals I'll show you as we go along. In this situation, you have to times it by 3 to make it equal to 3.9, which can be then rounded off to 4. But in this situation here, We could do that just by multiplying it by 2. Now, once I have the whole mole number ratio, I know that my alkene has to be 2 moles, oxygen has to be 15 moles, and carbon dioxide has to be 10 moles. Now, the next question says, use this ratio, try to figure out what could be the formula of the alkene. Now, the trick is, the moles of carbon dioxide is a reflection of the number of carbon atoms present. You know, alkenes are made of carbon and hydrogen. Now, if there is going to be 10 carbons here, because there is 10 moles of CO2. Remember, each mole of CO2 is 1 mole of carbon. So I see 10 here, and since there is 10 CO2, I know for sure there has to be 10 carbons. Now, don't forget, it's an alkene. Now, alkenes have a general formula, CnH2n, which means the number of hydrogen has to be twice that of carbon. So that explains why this is 20. And that's how we get the formula of the alkene. Now, for the next part of the question, it says construct an equation to show complete combustion of this alkene. Now, since we are with the alkene that we have has a formula C10H20, and when we say complete combustion, that means we are going to get carbon dioxide and H2O. Now, the trick to balance these hydrocarbon combustion equations is a very, very simple trick. Whatever number of carbon you see here, put exactly the same number here. That's 10. Done. Check the number of hydrogens. You see there are 20. Whatever number you see here, just divide that by 2. So 20 divided by 2 is 10. And that's how we get this number. The reason is 10 times 2 is 20. Now for the oxygen, that's the one which should be balanced at the end. The trick is to add all the oxygen that you see here. 10 times 2, that's 20. And this 10, which means there is 10 oxygen there. Don't forget this 10 is for hydrogen, also for oxygen. Now that gives you a total of 30 oxygen on your right hand side. Whatever number you get, just divide this by 2. The 30 divided by 2 is 15. And that is how we write 15 here to balance this equation. Right, let's have a look at another example of a mole concept question. This question I picked up from paper 32, November 2012. So make sure you have a copy of that question. And if you just go to question number 5 of that exam, D part, you will find this calculation question there. Okay, so I'll wait for you till you get everything in order. And let's have a look. Now this question gives us a ratio. It talks about sodium sulfide reacting with excess hydrochloric acid. Now be careful of this term. That means I really cannot use any information of HCl in my mole calculations. Anyway, the question has given you nothing about HCl. But it did give you the mass of sodium sulfide as 3.15. If you notice carefully, it also says mass of 1 mole of Na2SO3 is 126. Remember, mass of 1 mole of anything, it means the MR. So that's why the MR of this is given 126. Even if they had not given you the MR, you could have used your periodic table to figure this out. According to my equation, I get 2 moles of sodium chloride, 1 mole of SO2 and 1 mole of H2O. If you look at the question, it says you need to figure out what's the maximum volume of SO2 will you get. This is a classic mole concept question. They're asking you about SO2, but they didn't give you anything about SO2, which means you need to first find out some about moles of what they gave you, which in this case is Na2CO3. Since this is in excess, it clearly means this must be the limiting reagent or the limiting factor, the one which controls the whole reaction. Because the moment this finishes, the entire reaction shuts down. So let's have a look at how to find the moles. In my previous question, I taught you how to find moles when you have mass of a molecule. Remember, it's a molecule. So the formula to be used, once again, let's try to find moles of Na2SO3 should be equal to mass by MR. Now, in this case, the mass is 3.15 and the MR is 126. So let's figure this out. 3.15 divided by 126. That gives us 0.025 moles. Once we get the moles of Na2CO3, using the mole ratio between these two, you need to connect the mole ratio between Na2SO3 and the SO2. Since the mole ratio between them is 1:1, how do you know it's 1:1? If there's nothing written here, that's 1. There's nothing written here, it's 1. So that's why it's 1:1, which clearly means if one of this gives one of this, so much of this should obviously also give you 0.025 of SO2, because it's just 1:1. So whatever value is here, you get the same answer there. Now, once you get the moles of SO2, don't forget it's a gas. And the question talks about the volume of the gas at RTP. And the moment they say volume of gas at RTP, that means you have to use this formula, N equals to V by 24. This is how to find moles of any gas at room temperature and pressure. Now, I have the volume, but remember, the volume always has to be in dm cube. Now, the question says, find the volume of the gas. That means I already have the moles with me, so I need to find V. So we can make V the subject. V equals to N times 24. So I have the moles 0.025, times it by 24, and that's how we get 0.6 dm cube as the answer. Okay, for my third question today, I picked up question number 8 from paper 32, May 2013. This question starts off by asking students, define mole. Well, mole is basically a collection, or is a number of particles, which is exactly equal to what it would be if I give you 12 grams of carbon. So the number of particles, which is exactly the same, which belongs to 12 grams of carbon, is actually 1 mole, which actually is 6.02 into 10 to the power 23. So basically, so many particles would constitute 1 mole. The next question actually asks you, what is Avogadro's constant? Well, that's the number there. That's the Avogadro's constant. Or you could say, it's the number of particles present in 1 mole of any substance. Now let's have a look at the B part of the question. In B part of the question, it says they've given you four different molecules, and they give you all their masses, and they want you to find out which two of them will have the same number of molecules. Now the easiest thing what you could do is to find moles of every one of them. So they give you 2 grams of CH4. To find the moles, remember as my earlier question, if you want to find the moles of anyone, you just have to divide mass by the respective MR. So that would be 2, the MR of CH4. Don't forget carbon's AR is 12 and hydrogen AR is 1. So that's 12 plus 4 times 1. That's how it becomes 2 over 16, which turns out to be 1 over 8. I did not calculate the molecules yet. I'm just calculating the moles and I'm keeping it there. Now, why don't you try the other ones yourself? 8 grams of oxygen, 2 grams of ozone, and 8 grams of SO2. So why don't you try to do this question by yourself using the same concept there? So let's check whether your answers matches my answers. To find the moles of this one, I'm going to take 8 divided by the MR of oxygen, which is 16 times 2. And this becomes 8 by 32, which is 1 by 4. If you look at this one, it's 2 divided by 16 times 3, which becomes 2 divided by 48, which is 1 by 24. Similarly, for the SO2, it's 8 divided by, we have sulfur. Well, this is 32, and that is 16. That's the atomic number, that's the AR. So that's 32 plus 2 times 16. And that gives us 8 divided by 64, which is 1 by 8. If you notice carefully, this and this are same, which means if I go on and calculate the number of molecules, these two will have the same number of molecules. Don't forget, if you want to change moles into molecule, you need to times it by the Avogadro's constant. So remember, number of molecules equals to moles into 6.02 into 10 raised by 23. But you really don't have to do that, because when the moles are same, obviously the number of molecule also will be same. So that's how we do this question. Now, when we go to the C part of the question, it's given us an equation, calcium reacting with water to form calcium hydroxide plus hydrogen. This is an important equation, metals reacting with water. You'll find more detail in topic 10 of your syllabus. Now, they gave you the mass of calcium, they gave you the mass of H2O. Now, the question says, find out the moles of calcium. Now, to find moles of calcium, don't forget calcium is an atom, it's not a molecule. Since it's an atom, the formula to find the moles will be now M divided by AR, relative atomic mass of calcium, which in this case becomes 4.8 divided by the AR of calcium, 40. And this works out to be 0.12 moles. Similarly, why don't you try to find the moles of H2O yourself? Which formula do you think it has to be used? I mean, it's a molecule. Since it's a molecule, I have to use the formula M over MR. So the mass of H2O is 3.6. The MR of H2O from the periodic table, I have 2. Now, when you find the MR, don't multiply this by 2 here. MR means mass of 1 mole. That's just 1 H2O. So H is 1, so that's H is 1, and O is 16. So since there are 2 H's, that's 2. There's 1 oxygen there, that's 16. And that works out to be 0.2 moles. Now, when we go to question 8, C part 2, and this question says, which reagent do you think is in excess? Now, this is one of the very popular questions which keeps coming in the exam. And the best way to do this question is, you look at the equation, and you first of all write down calcium and H2O, and copy the mole ratio from the equation. Now, it clearly says there's no number before calcium, that means that's 1 mole. And in front of H2O, there is 2, so that's 2 moles there. So the mole ratio between them is 1:2. This is according to the equation. Now, these two numbers that you see are the moles that you calculated in the first part of the question. So you write down these underneath them. Now, the thing is, you really cannot compare these two numbers as of now, because the ratios are not same. Now, to make the ratios same, you could do the easy thing. What you could do is to divide this by 2. The reason is you want to make that equal to that. You could also times this by 2, but this is easy. Divide this by 2. Now, to be fair, you also have to divide this by 2. And that's how you basically get 0.1. Now, what you see is, you see that this mole ratio has become constant. It's become same, actually, sorry. So the mole ratio has become same between calcium and H2O. Since the mole ratio is same, now you are in a position to compare these two numbers. Now, if you look carefully, this one is in excess, and that's the one which is less. So that means this becomes the limiting reagent or the limiting factor, and this is the excess reagent. So that's how we figure this out, that out of these two, which was is in excess. So we clearly understand calcium is in excess. Now, to explain our answer, I have written the mole ratio after modifications, and I clearly see, because they were 1:1, I see that 0.1, which is less, that's the amount of moles of H2O which is required to react with calcium. That means 0.1 H2O will react with 0.1 calcium. So 0.02 calcium would be in excess. So the way to write in the exam would be 0.1 mole H2O will react with 0.1 mole calcium. And we clearly understand the moles of calcium is more than 0.1. That's basically how you tell the examiner why calcium is in excess. The third question says, find the mass of the reagent that you found out was excess in the previous question. So we know that calcium was in excess. So how much mass of calcium was really left? So first of all, you need to find out how much was the excess moles of calcium. So you had 0.12 moles of calcium, but out of that, only 0.1 will be used up. Don't forget, that's because the moles of calcium was equal to moles of H2 after we adjusted the ratio. So 0.1 of H2 will react with 0.1 of calcium. So that means 0.02 moles of calcium will be still left. Now, since the question wants you to find the mass of calcium, the formula to find mass of calcium, mass equals to moles into Ar, because calcium is an atom. So I have the moles of calcium and the Ar of calcium from the periodic table, and that's how we get 0.8 grams for this question. So I'll give you a few moments, why don't you open the question and prepare yourself for it. Okay, hopefully everything is there. You have the question with you now. And if you look at the question, they've given you an equation. And the moment they give you an equation, always have a look at the mole ratios. We have 2 moles here, 1 mole there, 1 mole there, and 2 moles there. If you read the question, it also gives you the volume of silver nitrate, 100 cm cube. It also gives you the concentration. Don't forget, anytime you see mole per dm cube, that's concentration. They also said mass of 1 mole of silver nitrate, that's the Mr, is 170 grams. So they give you everything for silver nitrate. So if you look at C part 1, the first question, it talks about why do you think the concentration of silver nitrate and potassium chromate 6 are different? Well, the reason why their concentration would be different, if you notice carefully, the mole ratios are different. According to the equation, clearly 1 mole of this needs 2 moles of that. So a simple answer for this question would be, since the mole ratio is different and 1 mole of K2CrO4 needs 2 moles of silver nitrate, and that's enough for this question. Now, when you look at the second part of the question, it says find the mass of silver nitrate that you think you require to prepare this solution, this much volume and this much concentration. Now, to find the mass of silver nitrate, you need to go a step beyond. You need to first find out the moles of silver nitrate. You've been given volume, you've been given concentration, since both the factors are there. So to find the moles, you can use the formula N equals to C times V. This is the formula to find the moles when you're working with solutions. Now, all you have to do is input the numbers. So N equals to, well, the concentration is 0.2. The volume is 100, but don't forget, this is 100 cm cube. You cannot use cm cube. You have to change this into dm cube. So 1 dm cube is equal to 1000 cm cube. So basically, when you want to go from small unit to big unit, you divide. That's why this gets divided by 1000. And when you work this out, you will get the moles of AgNO3. So let's do 0.2 times 100 and divide this by 1000. You get 0.02 moles. Once you have the moles of silver nitrate, to find the mass of silver nitrate, now you will use the formula moles into Mr. And the reason why you're using Mr, because that's the molecule. Now you have the moles from this previous calculation here, and the Mr is given in the question, 170. So when you times that with 170, the answer that you get is 3.4 grams, and that's basically how you find this answer. Now, moving on to C part 3, the first question says, here this question wants you to find the mass of Ag2CrO4, which you could get from 20 cm cube of silver nitrate, whose concentration is 0.2. So they gave you 20 cm cube of this. They also gave you concentration 0.2 mole per dm cube. The first question they ask you is to find the moles of silver nitrate. So you're going to use the same previous formula that you used in the previous question. So N equals to C times V, because you're dealing with the concentration of a solution. So you have 0.2 as the concentration, the volume is 20. Don't forget, earlier I said you cannot use cm cube. You have to change that to dm cube by dividing it by 1000. So that's, when you solve that, you get 0.004 as your answer. Using that answer, you're now supposed to find the moles of Ag2CrO4. Now, if you notice, the question never gave you anything of Ag2CrO4. So that's where the mole ratio concept comes in. So to do that, to find the moles of this, you could connect this to the moles of silver nitrate that you got in the previous question. So when you look at the mole ratio, so you need to refer back to the equation and check the mole ratio between them. I see there is nothing in front, so that's one. I see there is two here, that means this is two. So one of this is being formed by two of these. Now, I have the moles of silver nitrate here, which is 0.004. So all I need is to find the value of X. A simple cross multiplication can do that. So X will be equal to 0.004 divided by 2, which is 0.002 moles. So that's basically how we get the moles of Ag2CrO4, just by using simple mole ratio. The third question says, use this information to find the mass of Ag2CrO4. Let's have a look. By this time, you probably might have got the idea. To find the mass of Ag2CrO4, once again, because it's a molecule, the formula would be N times its MR. Now, we got the moles from the previous question, which is 0.002. And if you notice carefully, there is MR of Ag2CrO4 given as 332. Don't forget, if they don't give it to you, you can use your periodic table to find it. So when you multiply these two numbers, you get 0.664, and that's the final answer of this question. Well, that's it, students. I have done questions from four past papers for you in this video. I hope you have gained some kind of insight in mole concept. So why don't you try to do some more past paper questions now? And hopefully within a few days, I'll put up another video and you could cross-check with me. All the very best.